LeBron James is the best player in the NBA, if not the world, right now. We're not talking about in 5 years from now. We're not talking about really even legacy. We're talking about the best player in the league right now. I think it's, without a doubt, LeBron James. Now, ESPN, they put out their top 10 players who they think are the top 10 players in the league right now. And they also came to the same conclusion that LeBron James deserves to be number one. Now, I do think there is a race, really a two-person race between LeBron James and, of course, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Who was the better player of the two? You would throw in a third player in Kevin Durant, but for the time being, you have to kind of disqualify him just because of the injury. We don't know how he's going to come back from the injury. It's a very difficult injury to come back from. I don't really doubt that he can't come back from it, but of course, it's a major injury. And two, we just haven't seen him play in a little under a year. So it's been a while since we've seen Kevin Durant play in real basketball games. So I think for the time being, you have to exclude him. I think if he's healthy and he's anything close to the old Kevin Durant that we've seen before, yes, you could throw him back in the conversation. So now you go back to Giannis and you go back to LeBron James. Now, admittedly, I've never been the greatest LeBron James fan, mainly because I'm a very competitive person and I'm a diehard Los Angeles Lakers fan. So during LeBron's first tenure with Cleveland, right, the Lakers were his competitors. And then his early time with the Heat, the Lakers at that point were still his competitors. So for me, and really anybody that has that competitive gene, you respect the greatness, right? You respect the great player that is LeBron James or whoever the great player is at that time. You respect the person that could be an obstacle who you're chasing and you're trying to beat. But at the same time, you're all about your team and you're trying to beat that guy. But you still respect that player. Always respected LeBron James and his skill set and what he does for teams and what he does really for the city of Cleveland and really just for the league in general. Really has uplifted the league, and he's shown that you could dominate a different way, because we've seen a Michael Jordan and how he dominated in that aura and that killer instinct that he had. We've seen that somewhat replicated with Kobe Bryant. LeBron James has led and has dominated in a completely different way. Now, although I might be a guy who has a preference to Michael Jordan or Kobe Bryant type, I still respect and I still acknowledge how LeBron has uplifted a lot of his teammates to get them to perform to their best capacity and to be able to still make the finals year after year after year. What he did against a team like the Warriors when they won 73 games and still able to win that series. A lot of that stuff has been remarkable, what he's been able to do. Now, playing for the Lakers, of course, I'm really rooting for him because I want our Lakers to win. So that is a key reason. But taking all that aside, I still think he's the best player in the NBA. Now, Giannis Antetokounmpo could be one of the guys, him and Luka, I believe, that could be one of the most talented guys for years to come. But right now, I don't think Giannis is 100% there yet. I don't think his game is as well-rounded as LeBron James. Yes, Giannis is beginning a better jump shot. He has been shooting at a better rate. I don't think he's there yet. Defensively, I think he's good, but I think he could go up another gear before he's really at that elite, elite level. Giannis also has that team that's perfectly orchestrated around him, and I think they bring the best out of Giannis. But we need to see Giannis kind of take his team over to that next level, which I think he had a chance of doing potentially this year. We'll see how everything ultimately plays out. But LeBron right now, still at another level. At his age, being able to defend again, I think having Anthony Davis really pushing LeBron James on the defensive side of the ball has helped out the Lakers, has helped out LeBron and his game, because we've seen some remarkable defensive plays this year from LeBron. He's still able to pull the best out of his teammates. He still does it this year, even with the Lakers. And a lot of guys still play better with LeBron than without LeBron. You see, you know, how the Lakers are really turning into a team that I think a lot of people consider maybe the best team in the league as we got towards the end before, of course, the season being postponed. The Lakers are rolling. The Lakers are absolutely rolling. He still can shoot. He can still get to the rim at will. You do see some of the athleticism kind of, you know, regressing a little bit, but he can still get to the rim at will. Free throw shooting is something that LeBron needs to work on. When he gets to the free throw line, it's kind of, you kind of hold your breath. kind of holds your breath, especially if it's late in the game. But overall right now, not many holes in LeBron's game. I think he's well-rounded. He's still great at certain things, playmaking. His IQ and getting to the basket is still at an elite level. He's still a good defender who can, you know, make those plays at a key time at an elite level as well. So right now, LeBron James, without a doubt, the best player in the world.